Though it has been a busy week for Labour and for Jeremy Corbyn. First, there was the party conference. Then Jeremy Corbyn ventured to Scotland for his first trip since being elected leader. The party fared disastrously in Scotland at the general election, losing all but one of their seats as the SNP swept to victory. But with a new, more left-wing leader and Jeremy Corbyn saying he wants a kinder politics, will those voters who abandoned Labour start to return? Well, one of the Labour MPs...
Rain cannot damp the excitement as the first results come in of Britain's 1955 general election. Crowds throng Piccadilly Circus to watch the score.
A massive switch to Labour and a consistent one that hasn't changed in the first half of the campaign.
Scottish Parliament adjourned on the 25th day of March in the year 1707 is hereby reconvened.
Alex Salmond, Scottish National Party, 19,507.
The result in Fife has taken the no campaign over the line, and the official result of this referendum is a no.
You know, the political firmament, the tectonic plates of Scottish politics have shifted tonight. What we're seeing is a historic watershed.
Well, one of the Labour MPs who lost their seat at the election is Dame Ann Begg. She joins us now live from Aberdeen. Extraordinary just watching through the dates there and how Labour's fortunes have changed so dramatically in Scotland. What do you think was behind the change?
I think there was a change of mood amongst people, but I think there was also a very clever campaign that was waged by both the Yes campaign and the SNP in particular, where they managed to sell two very erroneous positions. One was that Labour was just the red Tories. That had a degree of resonance. But the second one, which was also particularly worrying, was the accusation that anyone who voted no in the referendum was somehow anti-Scottish, that to argue that Scotland was better in the Union and stronger in the Union was actually to do Scotland down, and that did have a degree of resonance, not just through the referendum, but during the general election as well.
So how do you see Labour's fortunes now with Jeremy Corbyn in charge?
Well, it's difficult to see how they can get any worse, I have to say. There are things that that hopefully Jeremy Corbyn will help to address. Well, I wasn't someone who voted for Jeremy Corbyn, but I think he has to be given his place and his chance to turn things around. So he's able to help with regard to the left-right split as to whether the accusation that Labour is now a right-wing party certainly can't be made with him as our leader. And hopefully in areas such as Glasgow, where there's a very large Labour vote, a traditional Labour vote, then that might work. But that in itself won't be enough. And we also have to show that actually, as a Labour party, we have Scotland's best interests at heart. We stand up for Scotland. We want the best for Scotland. And what we think of being the best for Scotland has been part of the United Kingdom. Now, that's down to Kezia Dugdale, her new leader in Scotland. She's very young, dynamic, and I think can take on Nicola Sturgeon and the SNP and show that Labour is a forward-looking modern party.
Well, let's bring in a few others from across Scotland, former and current Labour voters amongst them. We've got Denise Finlay from Dundee, who was a Labour member until last October when she decided to join the SNP. We've also got Saffron Dixon, who is a member of the SNP. She's in Glasgow in Huntly near Aberdeen. We have Stephen Duffus, who is also an SNP member but went to a Jeremy Corbyn rally. Denise, first of all, ex-Labour member, now vote SNP. Why was that?
Well, after the referendum, when Labour stood with the Tories effectively against the people they're meant to represent, and they used like Tory money, Tory tactics in order to demonise the Yes campaign, I saw them for what they really were. And I didn't see them as having Scotland's best interests at heart. I think they have the interests of the Labour Party at heart at all times. And so that's why I moved to the SNP. But I have to say, the SNP do a fantastic job of running Scotland. The education is very good, education outcomes are great, youth unemployment's low, the crime is the lowest ever, and they tackle all our problems, such as, you know, within life expectancies and things. They're building things like bridges, hospitals, universities. So I think they do such a good job of running Scotland, and so therefore we want to get more powers to Holyrood, because obviously the Scottish Government is better at running Scotland than Westminster, and we were promised more powers, and I hear nothing from Jeremy.
Nothing from
Ann Begg on more powers.
Sounds like you're firmly in the SNP camp. I'm just wondering, can Jeremy Corbyn win you back to Labour?
The only way Jeremy Corbyn could win me back is if he joined the SNP, and to be frank, he'd be more comfortable in the SNP than with the party he has, because he doesn't seem capable of leading his party. His party is split. I don't see that they can offer a good opposition in Westminster. And if he was serious about an opposition in Westminster, he would be speaking to Nicola Sturgeon today, not Labour activists.
Stephen Duffus, you voted for the SNP, but you've been to a Jeremy Corbyn rally. Is he winning you round?
I wouldn't say he's winning me round. I'm willing to give him the time of day to listen to his arguments. But picking up on a point that Anne made, I would agree that there was a change of mood, but I do also think that it highlights the sort of main grievance with Scottish Labour in Scotland at present, that they've kind of taken the electorate in Scotland for granted, highlighting the kind of the way that if you voted no, you was kind of alienated as being anti-Scottish. I'd say it's a lot more to do with the fact that the SNP's rise is a lot more to do with the fact there's such a disillusionment with Labour taking the Scottish vote for granted.
Do you think with time that might change, or can you see switching from SNP to Labour, or is that now something that is formative in your view?
I would say I think the problem with Jeremy Corbyn and John McDonnell is they have to realise that they've got to offer something to Scotland, which is something that Labour hasn't done for many years. They have to develop policies that are beneficial for the Scottish people.
Saffron Dixon, SNP, but in Scotland, but you support Jeremy Corbyn in England. Is that where you support Labour in England? Is that right? Just outline your position for us.
Well, yeah, SNP, but I support a lot of Jeremy Corbyn's positions and a lot of these policies, because naturally I'm a social democrat, I'm on the left wing, that's who I am. I'm a nationalist as well, but before I'm a nationalist, I'm a socialist. So of course I'm going to support whoever has the best socialist policies in the UK. That doesn't mean that I'm going to support Labour or vote for Labour anytime soon, but I think it's essential that we recognise the things that are good across the whole spectrum, even though I am in the SNP and I plan on continuing to be in the SNP.
For you three, Denise, Stephen and Saffron, is there anything in particular that Scottish Labour could do, or Jeremy Corbyn as the overall Labour leader could do, that would make you think again about Labour?
The only thing that Scottish Labour could do that to make me want to vote Labour would be accepting Yes voters. The way that I feel Scottish Labour has conducted itself with Yes voters has been completely ridiculous. The assumption that everybody who's in the SNP and everybody who votes for the SNP feels like people who voted no are anti-Scottish. We don't. Just the same as everybody who, not everybody who voted no assumes that every single SNP voter is anti-English, because we're not. The campaign that they ran is a very bitter and a very poisonous campaign. And until they accept independence, I can't find myself ever wanting to vote for Labour.
I would never vote Labour again, because I can never forgive them for what they did in the Better Together campaign. But my problem with Jeremy Corbyn is yes, he does have the policies that I would agree with, a lot of them, but he cannot deliver those policies because he can't take his party with him. And they will not go into the voting lobbies with Jeremy Corbyn to form an opposition in Westminster with the SNP. If he can't persuade his party, he's not going to be able to persuade England. And to my mind, that means that we're stuck with Tory governments for decades, unless we get independence, which I hope we do. So it makes me actually more determined and more determined to support the SNP and support independence. And I just don't feel that Jeremy Corbyn is offering anything to Scotland. Where's our new powers? Because we are not getting them. The Scotland Bill is completely inadequate.
OK, well, let's go back to Anne, because, Anne, I wonder, what listening to the three of them, what you're thinking then about the future for Labour in Scotland?
Well, it does reflect exactly what I said, is that actually the whole national identity issue was probably the biggest issue that affected the way that people voted, rather than anything to do with the right or left wing. There was an element of that, but mostly it was about Scottishness and being what is best for Scotland. But listen to at least one of your contributors saying that Scotland's done nothing for Scotland. You know, we've got a Scottish Parliament because of the Labour government in 1997, and that's Scottish Parliament is about to get a great deal more powers, and Labour has delivered on that with regard to the powers. A lot of people in Scotland don't know what powers the Scottish Parliament already has. They are quite extensive, and still Westminster gets blamed for everything that goes wrong in Scotland. The SNP gets credit for anything that goes right. But we do have some serious concerns around some of the policies of the SNP in Scotland, particularly the centralisation of things like the police force and the mistakes that have been made by the police force, or indeed the underfunding of the colleges. Working class kids go to college more often than they'll go to university. The university students are doing quite well out of the SNP, but college students can't even get a place because the college numbers have been cut in order to pay for higher education. So there are things that, as a socialist, that the SNP are doing that I take great exception to.
I know you're all itching to get back in, but I'm afraid that we have to end our debate there. But we loved you all joining us. Ann Begg, Denise Finlay, Stephen Duffus and Saffron Dixon. And you can keep it going. Get in touch with us via social media and we can keep this debate going. And your voices will be heard as well if you join in the debate as well. Also, still to come today, more from...